SDU was founded in 1864. It was originally located downtown where the Performing Arts Complex is right now, but eventually they moved it to where it's currently located, and the first building that was built was University Hall. We're also listed in the Constitution of Colorado as the Colorado Seminary, although we are no longer technically the Colorado Seminary, but nobody wants to go through all the trouble of fixing the Constitution, so we're still listed there as a Colorado Seminary, even though it's not true. University Hall, as I said, was the original building on campus. It was also the only building on campus. It held everything from the gymnasium on the basement level, dormitory rooms on the top floor, and a library, museums, classrooms, and the chancellor's office in the rest of the building. But now University Hall holds the Office of Admission, Financial Aid, the Bursar's, and Registrar's Office. In 1919, back in the day when we were big football rivals with Colorado School of Mines, they decided it'd be a good prank to set off 4 sets of dynamite on the building. So it shattered all the windows, destroyed all the reinforcements, but we still won the football game. So that's karma. Mary Read was, the money to build Mary Read was donated in the height of the Depression by Mary Read, who was one of our alumni and faculty members. So it was built in the height of the Depression, and it was our library at the time. So back then, students decided that the typical way of checking out books was not how they wanted to do things, so they would oftentimes just open the windows and throw their books out on the lawn, go out there and retrieve it. So that's a rumor why the Penrose Library was not built with opening windows. Now, Mary Read is rumored to be haunted by Mary Read herself and Mrs. DuPont, who was another professor at DU, but it also holds the oldest functioning elevator west of the Mississippi. Now it holds the office of the chancellor and the provost and some classrooms, and the Renaissance Room is still there, which was the library, and it's very beautiful in there. Marjorie Read was the daughter of Mary Read. She was a fine arts student at DU, and so it used to hold the theater department, but we have since moved to a newer location in Johns McFarlane Hall. But Marjorie Read now is the office, or the administrative offices of the Daniels College of Business. But they also used to hold the graduation ceremonies on the steps of Marjorie Read, and the students and faculty would sit on Carnegie Green. Evans Chapel was originally located downtown, but when they decided to tear it down, the chancellor at the time of DU decided to bring it to the DU campus. So they took it apart brick by brick and put it back together on DU's campus, but when they did so, there was still one brick left, and they don't know where that brick goes to this day. Evans Chapel was built by DU's founder, John Evans, in memory of his daughter, Josephine Evans Elbert. It was originally located downtown on DU's old law school campus. And technically, Evans Chapel is the oldest building on campus. So the Bucktail Memorial Tower was burnt down in a horrible fire in 1983. So all that you can see today is all that was salvaged from that fire. But it took a number of years to complete because of DU's constantly fluctuating financial health. It started to be built in 1907, but they didn't finish it until 1917. And in 1949, it was renamed the Bucktail Memorial Chapel in honor of Chancellor Bucktail. And the bell in the tower only rings twice a year, once during Pioneer Passage when we welcome students into the school their freshman year, and once during commencement when we ring them out of the school. So it's kind of a nice little tradition. So Johns McFarlane Hall was built between 1956 and 1957. And back then it was called Johnny Mac originally. It cost $1.7 million to build, and it was funded by the Federal Housing and Home Finance Agency. Johnson McFarlane, the name, is in honor of two longtime teachers at DU, Granville Bradby Johnson, who was a professor of physical education, and Ida Cruz McFarlane, who was a professor of English. It's still pretty much in the same state that it was back then, but renovations have been made, including making it one of our LEED Gold certified dorms on campus that they did just this last year. The Daniel L. Ritchie Center was completed in the fall of 1999. It's 400,000 square feet and it cost $70 million to build. It's named after Chancellor Emeritus Daniel L. Ritchie, who served at DU from 1989 to 2005. Chancellor Ritchie, who was known as a philanthropist, he sold his mountain ranch in Kremlin, Colorado, donating over $50 million to the university. Well, as I said, Mary Read was the library up until Penrose was built, and Penrose was built in 1972. It's rather retro chic since it was built in that era, so they wanted to build something that kind of matched the quality of the resources that the Penrose Library has. So they're completely renovating it this year. They're gutting it, and all they're using are the reinforcements on the building to build the new Penrose Academic Commons area. The Commons area is going to have a lot of awesome resources for students, including great study spaces. There's going to be 1,864 seats for students to sit in to honor when we were founded, 1,864 outlets as well. It's kind of interesting. But there's going to be tons of study spaces. It's going to be very technologically advanced with computer monitors big enough for groups to look at and share their projects that they're working on. There's going to be lots of meeting spaces, including one very large kind of conference area in the center that's going to be all glass windows around, so you're kind of in like a fishbowl. Lots of natural lighting. There will be a digital media center in addition to our research center, writing center, and math center that will help students with things that they're working on in class that aren't just your typical essays and whatnot. So if you're working on movies or PowerPoint presentations or anything like that, they'll be happy to help you with that. So it's just really exercising the fact that DU is becoming such a technologically advanced space or campus in addition to how students are learning these days rather than just, you know, searching through the book stacks now. They're much more reliant on technology and the internet and each other and working in groups. So the Penrose Academic Commons hopes to facilitate that.